put this straight for me. Let me share this with you. God in His wisdom selected this group of men and women to be the purveyors of His goodness. In selecting them through whom to bring about this phenomenon, He went not to the proud, the mighty, the famous, or the brilliant. He went instead to the humble, to the sick, to the unfortunate. He went right to the drunkard, the so-called weakling of the world. Well might He have said unto us, "Unto your weak and feeble hands I have entrusted a power beyond estimate. To you has been given that which has been denied the most learned of your fellows. Not to scientists or statesmen, not to wives or mothers, not even to my priests or ministers have I given this gift of healing other alcoholics, which I entrust to you." It must be used unselfishly. It carries with it grave responsibility. No day can be too long, no demands upon your time can be too urgent, no case too pitiable, no task too hard, no effort too great. It must be used with tolerance, for I have restricted its application to no race, no creed, and no denomination. Personal criticism you must expect. Lack of appreciation will be common. Ridicule will be your lot. Your motives will be misjudged. Success will not always attend your efforts in your work with other alcoholics. You must be prepared for adversity, for what men call adversity is the ladder you must use to ascend the rungs towards spiritual perfection. And remember, in the exercise of this power, I shall not exact of you beyond your capability. You are not selected because of exceptional talents. And be careful always if success attends your efforts not to ascribe to that to which you can lay claim only by virtue of my gift. If I'd wanted learned men to accomplish this mission, the power would have been entrusted to the physicians and the scientists. If I'd wanted eloquent men, there would have been many anxious for the assignment, for talk is the easiest used of all talents with which I have endowed mankind. If I'd wanted scholarly men, the world is filled with better qualified men than you who would be available. You were selected because you have been the outcast of the world. And your long experience as drunkards has made or should make you humbly alert to the cries of distress that come from the lonely hearts of alcoholics everywhere. Keep ever in mind the admission you made on the day of your profession in Alcoholics Anonymous, namely, that you are powerless and that it was only with your willingness to turn your life and will unto my keeping that relief came to you. And to that, I can only say amen. Now then, we're going to be talking about the ninth step tonight. You know, a lot of people, when they come in and they begin to look around and they look, we got these steps up here on the board where they're up here. Right in front of people, brand new people, got to come in and stare at those things and say, "Whoa, wait a minute. I got to do what?" And one of the things which is can be very terrifying right from the very beginning is this idea of having to make amends. Because, you know, if we look at ourselves, we look at our own histories, we can realize that a lot of this stuff is what we ran from. I mean, we did geographics to get away from this. We dodged the bullets. We ran. We lied. We procrastinated. We did everything in the world we could think of not to have to face the people we'd harmed. And here, we come in here and we think, at first, this is going to be a nice little benign program. It's going to kind of show me how I cannot drink, and everybody will love me, and everybody will know that I'm so sick, and they'll pat me on the head and say, "Good dog," and everything will be good.